I can't do it, and I hope it doesn't come as a shock to pass through this time. And after that, for those who realize it now, we offer what we call the complete run of the form with the effect. Hand out a copy, you will have it in read, then you can try to answer it, and then we look up for a very good former student who got a great pay for his presentation at the beginning. Is that fair, Dean? So we take that when you sign the course for 6 weeks. You know we have Easter vacation in America. You know it's 2 weeks? Because there won't be lectures on them, maybe there is only one for this course, because I think we started them. So we might have to do some, but we plan to do as follows. I've got already one suggestion that 21 could be one of the factors we have. Then we have 5 weeks. Have any of you other choices than 21? Or we will have 25, 21, 5 weeks in a row. No one else has any idea what they want to be. Let's do it. Then I will say 22, 20, 19, 15, and 40. That is what we call the Chinese way to solution. I think it could be okay to have a historical background too. Because it explains what has happened so far. But it's up to you to decide. So, this is my suggestion so far, but that leaves us a few other more confusion. So, what we don't do is we clear the numbers and start next time with 10. Next time with 10. Is that okay? So, we start with 10 for next time. And then you have a list of 6 where you put a priority to those left. And if it's only historical facts, you end up with 1, 2, 3, 4. So then it's 5 you have left. Okay? So that is up to you. So what you do now is go out in the street, have a let's say a banner, say 21, to all those supporting 21 runs up to 21. Then you make, let's say, nine ask for 21, then it's 21. Okay? So when you meet next Wednesday, you have been out for 6 days, where there have been a rally for 21, 20, 19, 15, and 20. Okay? And who will come to numbers? And you see a leader, you count how many supported the different chapters. Yeah? So we end up with 4 more in addition to number 5. And if there are strong objections, we will ask for an extra rally around the A building for 3 hours coming up with different chapters. So if you can find support from how many students that you can walk around the A building for 3 hours, you will change your selection, but not until then. Okay? So then I have 4 more chapters. That is precise. If I do not break up in my office for that former student and hear somebody shout down the no to number 50, no to number 50, for 3 hours. Okay? So I need 4 more chapters. Next time, I'm quite. And we will decide next time after 4 o'clock, not before last week. Okay? Then we have influence over the future. So then we cannot come back later and say, I have no influence. Now we have it. It is your life. Grab it, use it, and then you are using it. Okay? What happens when bricks enter into the world market? And bricks was That meant there were more goods to be consumed. What did they need? Was more that the import trade to produce these exporting goods. So all of a sudden, it was the room for developing countries to push into these markets. They are exports, not for import, they are exports. Because these large economies push export of goods into their markets. People, don't ask me, ask the Norwegians. But I think my T-shirt might have been produced in China. And if I bought it 10 years ago, it would have cost a bit to double. And now it's cheap. So they produce a lot of very cheap goods, push them into markets. But at the same time, they could afford more export. So they open up the export from the developing countries. Okay? So what we actually did was we imported our clothes from India, no, from China. Not beyond that, they were here. And if you had been a student at the start of this culture, it would be in a clothes production unit. In fact, the buildings where we have lectures like this, they have been producing clothes for the students. Why did we produce students instead of clothes? More efficient. Better for the economy. We can get cheaper clothes from China. We can get shoes from China, but most of the shoes are not from China. And not very cheap, because it's not very cheap to be in the country. Where is it? So, yes, we put our resources into knowledge. Drop producing what they can do to the time, but in the habits. So, yes, there was a room for more export, because these countries could afford more import. And the more they grew, the more they could import. Who could produce this? Most of the Western world were running out of to improve. Where could they get it from? Could they be imported? So, start to produce exporting goods from Brazil, sell it to China, or India, or so if you want to know that I include my fully agree with it, why on earth do we add tax to clothing production in the US? No competitive advantage. There are so much cheaper goods available in the world market. Why on earth should they produce it in the market where you don't know what it is? And it's not a place in Bangladesh, although it sounds like it could be, or in West Virginia. And if I say it's used in Norfolk, no one of you have been to Norfolk. But it's famous for one thing. I think it's one of the main bases for the US. So it's sort of claimed by the Chinese in Ukraine to Russia. So there they needed clothes, simply because they were not enough. They soldiers. And if you are a Marine soldier, on your way to the military, say to the North Pole, what I can guarantee that you need is very difficult. They have to be so detailed. We can understand why China was not very fond of the agriculture of the United Kingdom, simply because they couldn't lose it. But that is probably the only thing where Paris is 30 one of the major problems. Most of it is benefits. It was a success in the US, but that is 160 years ago. Even your great grandfather would remember 150 years back if he was a president. It's gone. That time is over. Now it's more clear. The first thing we do is to reduce that. So that is the answer to being a true impact. It's costly. You are wasting your resources. It ends up with inefficient, small scale production. Where they can do it in Bangladesh, but in large scale and largely much larger than you can think. Why should you do this in a small scale, in a small country, somewhere in the world, and you can do it cheaper, faster, better, at lower cost, and using competitive advantage to do it, to do it in Bangladesh? Is that a promise? So if you are the minister of trade and commerce in North and West Side, don't ask for tax on trade and commerce. It's not for me. Okay? So when I come to North and West Side Monday to see, say hi to you and say, nice to see you again, and let me test by your career so far. If I don't understand this tariff concept wrong, then you have to come up with a different argument than Kenya. Very often, we use this to domestic purposes. But why on earth put the pressure on trade when the problems are domestic? Okay? Okay. The next time I have a quarrel with my wife, that is a domestic problem. Okay. If I then walk over to the neighbor and knock him down and say, I have a problem, and he will look at me. Am I the problem? No, no. Have I caused it? No, no. But that is the only place I can knock somebody down. Because at home, I'm not allowed to knock anybody. So that is the point. It's a domestic problem. You cannot solve it by going to war. If that is the solution, I will have seen a very good Norwegian international football club. Because I want to know Norwegian players. I would play those in Italy that are, let's say, substitutes on the Italian international school. But thank you. But all I know from Cameroon, because they didn't qualify, we can lead it. So then I have a very good squad. But the problem is domestic. I can't go abroad. I can't cross it with those who are not responsible. We have a Norwegian player because, and none of the Norwegian players. It's a story that a Norwegian author wrote in the 1780s at the moment. In a small town, there were one smith and two bakers. One day, the smith killed his neighbor. Then the judge decided we had to kill somebody for the king. Since we have one smith and two bakers, can they kill this yet? No, I will not be evil. So what do we do then? We kill the baby. Because we have one extra. We didn't need two, we could do it. That is the way we try to solve trade problems. It's domestic. It has to be solved internally. Why do we set up with good trade policy? And that's it. So, do as the Norwegian didn't do it. Punish the guilty. And that is it. if you want to develop manufacturing industries in the developing world, make sure that they export. As Minister of Commerce and Trade in North and West Rhine, make sure that they export to Baden-Württemberg, to Munich, or somewhere else outside Europe. Because you can't export your products. If you can export, then you can afford the government. And what you need in North and West Rhine, you don't know it yet because you're not yet minister, but you will know one, is you need something we can produce ourselves. And we have to import. How can we get it? We have to pay for it. How can we pay for it? Export, export, export. If you want to develop, start export producing manufacturing. So if you wake up, let's say, on Thursday morning, or maybe you need a little bit of something, if you wake up on Friday morning and somebody in the building has asked you, what should I do? The tariff of import or subsidize export? The answer is subsidize export. Because you need to export. It's better to subsidize export than to tariff on import. So the best thing to do is support export producing companies. And what do they need? They need logistics. So make sure that they are skilled in logistics, or transport and logistics, to send them to Norway, where they can have a semester at the local college of logistics, or university of logistics. So when they come back to Norway, or maybe you will move down to Hamburg. They know how to transfer these things out of the building. And that is for the common. So, whatever you plan to do, make sure it's expected. Okay, it might have been right in the first place, because then there was little type. Now, in the 60s, it was much why should we do what we did in the 30s, which is a complete different product? Don't support import production when it is a growing world market. If it's a growing world market, it's cheaper. Let somebody else do that. Mexico has called a split experience. That is not because they now call the drug that it is also a kind of a mixed experience. According to, I think, the American media, this is one of the most influential persons. That is, if my influence is based upon somebody selling drugs for me, and that I treat them at regular or frequent time, I stick to teaching or lecturing in international economics, and I think that would be better for the world too. Don't you think so? But I could be better, eh? But that was the experience of Mexico. They had a mixed experience. So, it helped, or maybe didn't have too much. So, Mexico is not the best example when it comes to the alternative strategy. But it's communist made of the US. It has a free trade agreement. It's an exporting country. But I don't think we should be as Mexico did. Okay? So maybe the problem, since it's domestic, is simply this. Reduce the differences or the inequalities in the country. So that means those who own a beautiful world is not those who were students in the 60s, because that was the only thing they could afford. No. What is a beautiful world only today in France? It is a kind of a multi-million because it's very expensive to get a beautiful book. They can need half a million just to get one. And that is because they had to drive to Morocco to buy. And in Morocco, because of the riots and the crisis, they don't allow them to be exported unless it has a name. So the point is, yes, the problem is domestic, it begins in conflict, and the other body is working. So the other problem is, okay, if people just don't work, if they have nothing to do, then they are no income. If they have something to do, then they are no income. And income increases in the income. So maybe the problem is, wealth, employment rate, reduce the income, equality, inequality, and that. Should they start to produce assets or become Microsoft or become Exxon or GE? Very well necessary. You need not be a large scale producer. It need not be a Chinese scale for production. In many cases, I think most of the exporting products they have. So, small scale is more profitable than if you don't believe me, I would call it meat from Norway, I would call it Norwegian offshore supply vessels, and things like that. Obviously, no scale economy, obviously, very attractive, very, obviously, very expensive. Because we are the only producers. And the only place you can get it is like a new incident. If you wonder how it works, it should work for a country that wants to develop. Don't produce the origin of the incident, but do it when they are secure. So that is maybe the most profitable thing to do. Start to produce extra vessels, and that has given us its focus. Remember that the markets, the domestic markets are too small. You cannot make a efficient production if you are not exporting. So maybe that is the most, you say, favorite argument for export production. I think you've got, there are so few buyers working. The domestic market is so small, they cannot afford it without the fear of the state. Get more export. You remember that the new entrant in the world market will, in the beginning, be a smaller market. So even though in the foreign market it's small, because it's a new product. If you don't know how it works, I can tell you my favorite little story. In 1894, American producers of telephones came to Norway, to a small place called Vana. And they wanted to a business in Vana. All people in their village to put or join them in production of telephones. Okay? All these men, and they were old men, with pipes, knives, and jackets, maybe or something, and they said, okay, this looks like being a very nice thing for a house that they use to make their car. We don't think they are any money. First they went, where they went. Do you know anyone who has a telephone money? Yes. Not only a telephone, we have cell phones as well. And that is the other part of my favorite Norwegian story. One of the elements of these cell phones is a GSM system. This we developed. That's the Norwegian. I think there were two researchers at the Norwegian Technical University in Trondheim. They tested it out in Paris because it had to be shown to the companies that wanted to buy it in cost. And this was the only working system. So least in Norway, they may reach it. Touch will be relative. Both by Nokia. Is it a Norwegian company? Is it a small company? Do they have success with their cell phones? So, it is always a small market when you introduce new technology, new goods. So that is one. The local market is a reason, but normally it's not a huge market to enter into. You have to develop the market. So therefore, in the first place, that's why Nokia became big. Because they were famous. Because they were number one. So they were first. So very often, the question is, am I number one? Okay, then you have to realize you're going to make money. And if you don't believe it, call Nokia. But Nokia before it was taken over by the market. Okay? So there are potential markets. And that is the conclusion of Google. There are room for new ones. There are room for new products. Don't worry. Don't start to mess up your income. Start to develop. And experience so far, being in India, being in China, being in Brazil, being in Russia, there are room for more expansion. Why did it grow in Asia? Simply because of culture. They found somebody willing to pay for it. They are not from Asia. They are American or European. They came with them. So, if you look up the 11-2 and 11-1, you will see it's almost one-to-one relation between height and reduced height. If you reduce height, then you increase height. So, don't mess it up with the Northland Westfalen import system. Let it go and import. Because the money lies in it. And the more it takes, the more you get. And then we are back at the start. For those of you who remember this figure, which is this, and this, and this, and this. Figures, we don't call it T's and Y's. Let's call it cars. And if you pay, then you can consume up here because this can be imported and paid by collection. But in fact, the basic cost is okay. If you can split consumption and production, everyone pays. You get more value out of the resources. Not only more value out of the resources, you get more resources out of the resources. You use and utilize more resources. And if this is Bangladesh, it means more value. It simply means that there are a lot of labor, a value in the economy. Use them. Why should they sit at home and be hungry when they can do work to increase the value of your economy? As we said, in the beginning we didn't decide if we are either here, here, or in between. All of this indicates that we trade. Why do we trade? It's simply because we want more. And I don't want any of you to walk around with A building and say, you want more traffic, you want more traffic. Because what we want more is. And I cannot afford it if I cannot. And to give you, let's say, a bad reason. Norway buys more and more German cars because they need more and more electric gas and petrol.
something left out in those reports.
I think you would pay well in the public for each bird and egg you got. This is a look at the latest news on international media now. What has happened with the about 50 in the UK? The price of gold has gone up, 50 from its head, and price of oil. 50 from its frame, simply by more than more. It's not simple. And those could you buy natural gas if you're not buying from Russia and you're in need? Or Nigeria? We have it. You could buy from us. It's for sale, you do. Pay for it, but you have it. And that is the idea of non-import substitution structure. Do not miss it. Who will pay for your input? Pay for anything, the country, domestic. Are they generating more income? No, no. The answer is export. Export. But if you ask me, should I produce more petrol? As a Norwegian, I would say no. But as an international economy, I would say yes, because this is what we want. Here, we would have more customers in the Middle East. Second, here I agree with the children. There are so many economic factors in the exporting industry. It's generating people. It will improve the value within the economy. And you can do that here. And here you can see you can export even more. And the extra import is much bigger than the extra export because the value of the export is bigger. So, if you ask me, and I would have been an advisor to Julius Nyerere, he was head of a state, which once was a German colony. It was called Germany. East power is Africa. And none of you have done it. But if I say that one or several of my colleagues have been there because we exchange deals with this German East Africa. Well, Julius Nyerere was one for profit. And they were originally two states, an island and the mainland east. That was a German East Africa. And the island was called Sanfuda. And the country is called Tanzania. If Julius Nyerere had asked me in the 60s, and I had been old enough to tell, I would say, start export producing. Production. Because there is where the future is. And since it lies there, it's because of generous modernity, it is developing of the people, and including economic policy today. So, 10 minutes left. Trade policy is not the answer to domestic problems. The economic reform might explain part of it. But don't think that if you can reduce inequality and improve the employment rate, that is the best thing you can do. And that is the conclusion. The experience in the last 20 years is world welcomes new entrants. And what do we call the new entrants is BRICS, which is Brazil, Russia, China, India, and South Africa. And it's South Korea, it's Hong Kong, it's Singapore, and these other places. There has been no reason for the developing countries do not expand from prison, and they have been lucky. And this is the look of one of the crises it might be taking from some period. When you still doubt the technology of such a world. One of the weapons that sails around the world is produced in South Korea. Why? Because they produce series of large sailing vessels in South Korea. Have they been welcome? And the answer is, you have the more of it, the better you have, because you get better and cheaper sailing vessels, cars, because I think the car is just 200 or something. And the company could be Chinese. And Singapore is at least having one of the highest buildings in Asia. So if you want to see a big ocean center in Asia, you have to go to Singapore. So yes, a room for you, you're welcome, and if you come into this life, you will be welcome. So that was the happy ending of this chapter. Yes, a room for you, yes, it will be welcome. Have a nice weekend. We meet next Wednesday and decide what of the chapters we will choose. It was told in the newspaper in London that there are two international students in the hospital. I will come by with a piece of pickles and a chocolate. Yeah. And I will send a message to you.